Hello and welcome to the special 100th episode of The Legend of Heroes, Song of the Ocean, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. It's going to be a huge episode. They usually are anywhere between an hour and a half to like 2.5 hours, something like that. And yeah, I made a mistake last episode. I went the wrong way. I thought I was supposed to go here. I thought I came from here. Even watch someone else, like a little tiny bit of someone else's walkthrough to see how they got past it, and that didn't help me because they had gone this way when they were supposed to go this way. I was not supposed to go this way. So I really was starting to despair, thinking I encountered some game-breaking bug or something. I had gone back and talked to everyone in Clayta again, and it's a dead end. Oh. Yeah, I went to... Can't even find my way out of here. We will make it eventually. Just have to get back to Clayta and go the correct way. That's not that way. Okay. I need an overworld map. Let me go! So it's definitely not this way. And not that way. And this way is all dead end. Alright, so... it's gotta be... a way back the way I came. Okay, dead end tree. Can't go that way. Where the hell am I supposed to go? Don't get mad at me. I guess this way? Or is this going back to that soldier? Not completely sure. Let's see if it is. Okay, good. Alright, so here's Clayta. We weren't supposed to go to the south. We're supposed to go this way. Because that leads to a cave that we have not yet been to. This goes back to Gezalg. And now we are once again blind. All I know from this point is that we're destined to go in that cave at some point, and the soldier will let us pass because he's unable to get past traps or something like that. That's all I had seen from that walkthrough. And I was like, well, why can't I go? Because we're supposed to do this stuff first, and I didn't realize there were two ways out of there, so... that was my error. And I'm like, wow, I'm looking on Google, I'm like, I can't find anyone else who had a problem with this bug. So it didn't exist. There was no bug. McBain says, but I'm surprised that Captain Palman was the Prince of Numeros. But I think I understand, says Una. He's kind of classy. Unless he's like finishing his thought. Forte says he's really trusted by everyone. The Palman army really liked him too. The army. A requirement of a leader is for people to want to follow him. Captain Palman is good because he looks at things from the perspective of the general public. McBain's been saying all this. And he takes the lead no matter what the situation is. Leaders that stay in a safe place and order people to dangerous tasks is not a good leaders. Well, that's not a good grammars either, McBain. Captain Palman has all the necessary elements of being a good leader. His attitude of trying to help people without holding anything back is probably what makes him a natural leader. I see, says Ada. People won't follow leaders that are all talk. Now the people of Clayta are waiting, says McBain. Let's hurry to Gezalg. Well, you're the one who stopped us. Forte says, sure, okay. Where do we go? This way? Hopefully I'm not heading back to Clayton now. It's one of those cases where you just want a good map, you know? Give me the in-game map. This, how far is it? Oh, I can't walk through that now. It's gotta be close, right? We've been traveling for a little while. Thank God. There's, what's his name? Kiska? Oh, Forte. Oh, Kiska. The elder says, I was waiting for you. This way. How is Sir Ector? Are the villagers okay? Yeah, they're fine, says Forte. I met Sir Ector, too. Forte explained what happened at Clayta. He's digging a hole to destroy the Clayta factory? No wonder it's taking so much time. So, can you hang on calmly here for a bit longer? I understand, says Kiska. Leave Gezalg to us. You guys be careful, too. Please be careful and help Sir Ector as much as you can. Well, since yes, requested so nicely. Give my regards to Sir Ector. Tell him that I'm ready to help him whenever he needs me. Alright, but we're here for medicine, so we have to do that too. Okay. Guess we don't need the space anymore. We've already made the our monstrosity. Come back here. Yes, I came here to get arrested. This is my one goal in life. Alright, okay. He's the one we need to talk to. I am going to talk to him last, just so we can get in any other dialogue first. I'm doing my best, says Roraru. Please help Dad and Mom soon, okay? I'm doing my part. How are Mommy and Daddy? Would you tell them the Mina was worried about them? Do you always speak about yourself in such a manner? The Mina? Not only in the third person, but the Mina. Were the parents of these kids okay? It depends on how you define okay. Some of them not so okay. Hi. Halt, 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 halt. You weren't sent to Clayta? It's the same thing he said before. I'm gonna get some more of that armor. Thanks to them, we can't even go shopping in peace! Alright, is that it? Oh, this is... this also, yeah, I think this is it. I will not answer any of your questions. Oh, they were drunk before, really? He says, who are you? What are you doing here? This guy says, I'm in a bad mood. Every time I see a civilian, I want to beat him up. That's not good, says McBain. People that want to harm others for no reason are sick in the heart. What did you say? I'm in a bad mood, I say. McBain says, kids, pay close attention. These are the kind of people you need to despise. People that get emotional and express their emotions selfishly anywhere to anyone. It's so disgraceful. Arrgh, this is making me mad. You're so embarrassing, says McBean. Yeah, he said that before. We keep coming here very often, though. Extremely often. Alright, let's go get that medicine. Grandpa Ronald says, you need something? Are you Ronald? Asks Ada. Yes, I am. The people in Clayton are working very hard and they seem tired and worn out. We were asked to bring the royal herb that you make so they can recover quickly. Do you have any royal herb? Asks Forte.
Oh, really? Sure, sure. It makes me happy to know people trust me. I'll bring it right away. Hang on. This is the best to recover from being tired. Please share it with everyone.
Forte and his friends receive a royal herb. Wow, these are the royal herbs I've been hearing about, McBain says. Thank you, says Forte. We'll make sure we deliver it. This will make the people in Clayta happy, says Una.
Please, hurry and give it to them.
Leave it to us, says Ada.
Oh, we don't have to travel back? That's great.
Forte and friends got the royal herb and headed back to Clayta. Thank you, I appreciate that. It's like five screens we have to walk through or something. Ada says, we're here. Let's go deliver. We need to go in so that we aren't found, says Forte. Oh, yeah, no kidding. Alright, we'll go look around. Bother people. My station is closed for the night. Yeah, I don't think anyone hangs out up here. Oh, I'm thinking about it. Excuse me. Go back to U stations. Me stations are closed. Is this the same one I just talked to? Oh, no. It isn't, but it doesn't say anything new. So... Oh, look at that. Yeah, we're almost there, says the men. Huh. Palman says, hey, Forte, how are Kiska and the Elder? They were relieved for now. Here's the royal herb. Forte handed the royal herb to Palman. I forgot to look at it. Thank you. We're almost done, too. Just a bit longer. McBain says, well, it's almost time to destroy the factory. We need to go and help Capuri, too, says Ada. But there's one thing I'm worried about, says Palman. Bureger has sent soldiers into the Mirror Cave to get the Resonance Stone. Fortunately, they haven't retrieved it because they're having trouble with the traps that Leon has set. If they retrieve the Resonance Stone and they equipped it to the Wood Soldiers, that'll be some trouble. Well, if it involved Resonance Stones, it's our field of expertise, says McBean. Forte says, all we have to do is get the Resonance Stone before they do. Will you let us handle it? Asks McBean. A voice says, Sir Ector! Kiska's father says, it's time for the operation. The soldiers are calling for you. Ah, I must go. Let us handle the Resonant Stone problem, says McBain. Hurry, Sir Ector, says the father. The soldiers will become suspicious. I wanted to check on everyone else. I didn't realize. Okay, I'm not going that way yet. I'm the guard here. Huh. Okay. That was just a guard walking in right now. Well, these beds are empty now. Well, hopefully they didn't have any new things to say. So he's supposed to proceed through that tunnel then? No. Okay. So I think now we're supposed to go that way that didn't work for me, now it will work. Get away from that. Okay. Now we go this way. Now where is it? Over here? Figure out where you're going so I can get around you. You too. Hopefully it works now. But he's coming out of it. Ha, huh. Yeah, see, now it works. Soldier says, man, what is it with the traps here? Was it open, close, open, then push, raise, and push? I always end up stepping on them. Arg, I'm getting so mad. I think I'll go outside and take a breather. You are outside. McBain says, hey, Mr. Soldier. Grandpa? Who are you? What are you doing here? McBain says, I was asked to by Sir Bureger to help you. An old man like you? Don't make making fun of me because I'm old. Here, am I strong enough for you? Thanks. He just knocked him out. He's like stuck now. He's been frozen in place. Grandpa, it's time for a nap, he says. Let's go. The soldier is unresponsive. Alright, so I didn't think we'd be in a place like this. Mirror Cave. Right to left, left to right. Return the letters and all will match. Right to left. Left to right. Return the letters. What letters? Forte is like, hmm? What does that mean? McBain says, I guess the door will open if we can solve this riddle. Forte says, there are 18 same switches. Which ones do we need to step on? I guess so, huh? Says McBain. Right is left, left is right. Like a mirror, Una says. Oh, you call that a door? So some of them already stepped on. The They don't move. Are we supposed to match these? Just, I don't know what it's saying about letters, though. So these two. I'm literally just copying what's set over here, just in the opposite order. I don't know what it was talking about, letters. There are no letters here. The big scary monster scared of us. Should we fight it? Look, here's more. Okay, so now we're supposed to copy on the other side what's been done on this side. Let's save and kill. That would be a yes to that. Alright, so we're gonna go and kill. Go and kill golems. We're gonna regret this. Okay, doing damage with physical. Golems tend to be a wild card in RPGs. Some of them you cannot hurt physically, only through magic. Oh, what's she doing here? Oops. Ow, that hurts. Can I switch her out? Because, yeah, Una's supposed to be in the team. Not sure why that happened. And the dog has moved in the wrong... What's going on? Well, if they knock Forte out, I don't feel like going all the way back. We will revive him, that's all. Select new position. Yeah. I can't switch her out now because you only can do it in combat? It's kind of frustrating. Alright, so... The first one... And then the last three, right? Oops, I undo it by walking. Okay. Now they gotta keep putting them further and further apart. The two last ones... No, it's not. It's the two ones on either end, that's what I meant. All right, one more. First and third. Well, that's not solving anything. I guess I have it the wrong way. Alright, this is when I get tired of walking back and forth and I just take a picture with my phone. Done. Picture with phone. Let's go back to the other one. And back in the day, I would have taken a Polaroid, okay, so... let's see, I guess just... I guess it's this one? I hit the one on the wrong side. Alright, I'm like screwing things up. Which is the one that has the two end ones? I don't know. The two middle ones instead. I think it changes. Does it change with me? And then that one. So everyone except that one. The two middle ones. Actually, it's the opposite. Wait a second. That. And then... just reset that. I want to see if it changed over here. No, I don't think it did. I got 1, 2, 3. So if it's mirror image, right, this would be the first one on the other side. And is that the way I have been doing it? Good question. No. But I think that's the way I originally did it. So wait a second. That's supposed to be depressed in. There we go. And then these are depressed. That should be fine. This is the two middle ones. Nothing's opening. See, I'm running back here manual anyway. So, when you make a mirror image, right? So it's supposed to be... this one... it takes so long to walk back and forth. Yeah, I literally did it the same. So that's not a mirror image. No. So that goes up. This goes down. So then the other side... wait, which one's depressed then? This one? No. No, actually, this is the only one not depressed. Look. There we go. Yes. Access granted. I just noticed all these chests. What? They don't respond. Oh, that's cruel. You can't even try to open them? Yeah. I don't like that very much. Well, look at all these. Are we supposed to match the chests now? Oh my god. And then what's over here? Ugh. I could do without all this, you know. Just saying. Get out of my way. If you're not gonna open, get out of my way. Let's go up here. Right. So I have to mirror image the chests. So the first one here. Huh. Right. Let's fight this thing. That's out of our way. Get it over with. Put you out of your misery. Surprise the enemy, yeah. Get these ice spirits. Oh, wait. Ada, we're switching out. Sorry, and this time we'll actually be able to complete that. We need Una back. She has the resonant stones and the healing and all that fun stuff. Thank you. Loud rush. Missed. Get the other ice spirit. Missed with strong punch. Ice spirit, I want to finish them off first. Oh, and the dog's in the wrong spot. And I can change that, but I don't know how, because it doesn't move. I'll show you after the battle. Oh, that's great. I want Jan and Rick on the end where they used to be. I don't know why everything's changed around. That's wonderful. Oh, thanks. So paralyzed, but then well, killed or whatever, knocked unconscious. Fine. So, who's going? Forte. I don't know which golem is more injured. But we need to bring the dog back. Use an item for that. Oh wait, I have one of us attacking. Yeah, we're attacking both golems. That's not effective. Are we attacking the same one? I thought I had one attacking A and one attacking B. I don't know what's going on. Just kill them. Kill them. Come on, Una. Bring it home. Thank you. Yeah. That was a good amount of XP right there. Alright, so now we don't have to be worried about this thing running all over the place, trying to get away from us and running into us instead. So this is one on the other side, and then both sides. So we want this. Nothing in these, it's very cruel. Okay, now what happens? Did I do the mirror image wrong? Oh yeah, I did it wrong. I keep doing that. Still not seeing any change here. Right, so this would be... This is the leftmost one, so we'd do the right one. Oh, no, I had it right. Right, and this is the rightmost one, so we do the leftmost one. Well, nothing's happening. I don't know what to tell you. All right. Let me go. All right, so here's another. I'm gonna take another picture. Oh, jeez. Okay. I can't get... Everything's in your way in this place. Alright, the two ones on either side. You, and you. Oh. And then here also. Oops. Nope. And it should be these two then. So I guess the chests allow you to get past here because it looks like there's more here. Or here, I don't know. Nope, I'm gonna read it. Only ones that can defeat themselves are worthy of the truth. That sounds ominous. There's a large mirror. Woof! Grr, grr. What's wrong, Jan? Asked Forte. Huh? Hmm. A reflection in a mirror, says Una. Turn, 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 turn. Ada says, what the heck? The one that defeats oneself, says McBean. I guess this means that we have to defeat them. But we have to fight against ourselves, says Forte. This is a trial for us to overcome, McBain says. Mirror image encountered. Is there a particular mirror image we should be going after first? Do we just, like, fight like you normally do? Or do we have to have, you know, Forte fight Forte, McBain fight McBain, I don't know. I did damage. To interrupt that. Charge dog hit all of them. Nice, because they are lined up really nicely. That was great. Mirror image doing jump rush. Ow! Not so great on the other side of that. Oh, jeez. Bane's full. Alright. Kinda confusing, which one's the real one? Are there two there together? This looks like that I have selected here two together. I'm not sure. Well, I guess we'll fight McBain next. Peraran cure on selfies? Life full heal. Ah, heals one ally completely. McBain attacking McBain. Not so fast, buddy. Gaia Crush. Aim well. Huh. I don't know why they're all squinched together like that. You're messing me up. The dog's in the wrong spot. Well, actually, the dog can attack. That's fine. And then Una will do the life all heal. I'm not sure who we're attacking in that. Hopefully it's the same person that's already... There we go. Interrupt! Will anybody really get got the mirror images of Una and Janerick left? We'll fight Una now. Magic, Peraran. Thank you. Take it down. Yeah. Now we have to kill a mirror image of our dog. Very sad. Dog against dog. Dog wins. Wow. Getting close to level 31, some of us, most of us. Alright, so, hold on one moment. Okay. Gonna save now, because that was a thing. Oh, should we heal up first? Back. No, I don't want to overwrite the data. Back. Alright, so... Right, how do I do this? Right? Jan and Rick... Do I put them here? Doesn't work. Select a character. Select new position. It doesn't change. 3. Oh, it's the number. Oh, it's the number with the sword. They should just actually move the whole thing into... Never mind. Okay, so Forte... will be 1, thank you. And then... McBain shall be 2. Jan and Rick shall be 4. I don't know how they got messed up like that. Okay. Now we'll save. Forte and his friends obtain the Resonant Stone of Mirror. A mirror, McBain says. I guess all spells will be reflected. Una says, I wonder if recovery spells will be reflected too. I think so. The spells that are cast on it will be reflected back to the one that cast the spell. This is hard to handle. Why? Why is it hard to handle? Hard to handle? Hard for enemies to handle when you use it on them. Reflect spells, yeah. So what about the chests? Are the chests just there to torment us? These are the ones we can't open. This way... nothing new here. Right. Okay, so for this one we want... right, left, and then right and left. Just make sure I have it right. Right, left, right, and left. So I can't open these at all. or the others. Huh. Yeah, I don't know what that's all about. Maybe we had to fix both. We had to do both, otherwise that last... That's what I'm guessing. We had to do this and the other steps. Right? We had to do this and this to open that middle passage. So I'm guessing if we had done the little step stones first, we've seen nothing happen, and then if we did this last, then we would have seen the little pan over shot and see that the passage opened. Return the letters. I don't know what that's supposed to mean, return the letters. Okay, I guess we're going back to Clayda, because it's the only place we can go from here. And we can go on from Clayda and go back to the town, but there's no reason to go there, right? Maybe they'll be done, we'll be ready to explode the place when we get back. Explodey time! I like explodey time! As long as I'm not the one going exploding. Hmm. So the factory's open again, isn't it? Because those people are out of their beds. Oh, he's Captain Palman. Be relieved, says Forte. We got the Resonant Stone. Palman says, a wood soldier army has been dispatched to Gezalg. Bureger is planning on attacking Gezalg to see how his mass-produced wood soldiers perform. That's horrible, says Una. I'm heading to Gezalg too, says Palman. No, you can't, says McBain. Bureger is a smart guy. Maybe he's noticed us by now. There's a possibility that this is a trap to force you guys out. Leave Gezalg to us. Yeah, says Forte, and this is a chance to make preparations while Bureger is gone. McBain says, wood soldiers will continue to increase until we destroy this factory. It's your job to get rid of the source. You must complete the escape route, just as planned. I understand, Mr. McBain, and thanks to you too, Forte. Everyone, please be careful. What, no thanks for Una? No thanks for Ada? See if anyone's hanging around down here. I'm a guard. I'm the guard here. Please go and take care of Gezalg. We're okay here. Alright, so before that happens, we'll talk to some people, see if they say new things. Yeah, nothing new from the guards, anyway. Alright, so the only other building is that factory. So the factory's open now. They're working. This be it, I think. Somewhere, yeah, there's a door. I can't even try to open the door. Never mind then. I'll go back to my secret door. Where's the... Wait. How do we get out of here again? Wasn't the secret door right here? Forte, we can't get out from here. Oh no, there's another yard here. Never mind. Here we go. Okay. So we've seen that the way to Gezalg is this way. When they walk with us like that, I'm always afraid they're just gonna turn and run right into us. Sometimes they do. Not afraid, afraid, more like just like, well, that would be really annoying. Oh, that was a skip there. I'm gonna reset the recording. Way. Wish they would have just teleported us there. Automatically. Systematic. I almost ran into that. This way, I think? No, not really. I keep stopping because I need a new gamepad. Maybe this way. The down button sticks, as in stops working. No way through there, okay. Oh, it took too long to run there, they've all been slaughtered at the end. Resetting again. I don't know why it's doing this. But now we have different combat music, even though we haven't not been in combat this entire time. Oh, so we just gotta defeat all these, I guess? Or is there some scenario we have to help people? I mean, if it's just defeat all the wood soldiers in town, then that's fine, I can do that. But I'm not sure if that's what we're supposed to be doing, necessarily. Oh! How did you get in? What happened to the wood soldier at the entrance? Huh? You defeated it? No. I just walked past it. Wow! Can you keep this going and destroy all the other wood soldiers too? Please, save the town! Keep it going. Okay, we'll begin. How about that? Unfortunately, it's gonna be kind of, repetitive. Fighting the same things. One more hit. So maybe out of all this, we'll be able to buy some more of the armor for them. Do the exchange. Oh, nice. We get one, definitely. Ada has it. Oh, I got it all for everybody? So I don't need anything? Oh. Alright, never mind then. Back to fighting little wooden robot thingies. Why would they invade the town? They're already occupying the town. That makes no sense. Healing Forte. I don't even use it. So I'm just gonna destroy it this round anyway. Maybe like a bigger crowd of wooden soldiers. It would be more worth it. McBain, level 31, Una, Forte, Jan and Rick. It didn't make it this time. Oh. Mina says, "Wah! Kiska, I'm scared," says Roraru. "Don't worry, I'm here with you." Looks like you fight the rest of those things in the town first, though. I don't know. I don't see any in this area. I see a cat back there. Let's see if there's any more wooden soldiers. Yeah, it's no fair, even though I'm hitting them from behind, it's no longer, like, surprising the enemy. She couldn't even shoot. Wow. And she just appears out of nowhere. Oh, good. I surprised the enemy. Well, it's only one enemy. You are toast, buddy. I don't think Bane can reach. Oh, good. Another. Get back here. Oh, Oh, just one. Nice. They give him that's just one now. I like it. We're knocking it way too far. There's a robot, a wooden soldier inside here. Surprise, but there's three of them. No one can go. Interrupt. Ada, level 31. Welcome to the 31 Club. Alright, so this is empty because they're all huddled in the other house. Let's hope that door holds. Let me out. I think I forgot about this house. Like, I haven't gone here for a while. That's a copy of the Awakening of the Arch Enemy, I believe it's called. I've read that. Trying to have McBain reach. It's hard for them to reach in this scenario. I keep forgetting to interrupt. Yeah, Gaia Rush. I'm saving the charge dog. This is not a good, like, arrangement for it. Because he goes sideways across the screen. Alright, got that one. Down. Alright, in. Kill. Just one! You don't have a chance. Prayer in hell. Need to heal up a little bit. Alright. Okay. Small paro cure for the rest. That's enough. Okay. Ridding the houses in the town of this menace. Make sure I don't miss any. Then we're gonna go up to the elder's house. None of them wandering around in the elder's house. None of them went down here. I think we might have gotten all the ones in the town except for that house to the side where Kiska is. Let's go over there. Now this is a pretty good charge dog scenario. Oh, he's low on mana. Bow wow. Bow wow, I use item. Charge dog. Nice. Is this one? I don't think that one's damaged. Was he attacking C? Alright, well, you can't reach, so you'll attack that one. Last interrupt. Oh, we're about to get another one for Forte. Somehow that came from an arrow. Just go for this one. I don't care if you can't reach. Just walk over there. Okay, now we can get the other one. Forte! Kiska! The elder says, "Oh, thank you very much. Are you hurt anywhere?" says McBain. "I'm okay," says Kiska. Wrong voice. "How is Kleda?" "It's going as planned," says Forte. "Kiska, did you see Bureger with him?" "No, we were only attacked by wood soldiers." "Huh?" "Oh no," says McBain. "If the main army hasn't left Kleda, then..." Forte says, "Maybe. Is Kleda in trouble?" Were our surprise plans turned to be a surprise on us? McBain says, Bureger, he's got pretty good tactics. In any case, let's head back to Kleina. Kiska, take care of things here, okay? Leave it to me. You guys take good care of Sir Ector, too. Okay, good. If the attack on Gezalg by the Wood Soldiers were a decoy, then it's likely that Ambassador Bureger knew about Palman's plans. The people of Kleina are in danger. Fortane and friends decide to go back to Kleina. I'm going back to Kleina. 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 Grandpa, it's already started. Just as we thought. Where's Mr. Palman? Says Ada. That's Captain Palman to you. Who are you? Are you friends with these guys? Karutsu says, please, hurry to the basement of the exchanger. Please take care of Sir Ector. I'm gonna talk to them as they fight. Mina's father says, we have been waiting for you. Sir Ector is in the basement of the exchanger. I can't talk to the soldier. Gatekeeper. Yeah. These guys. No matter. Don't go easy on them. Well, I'm gonna look around and witness the carnage first, of course. There's not much carnage going on over here. I keep stopping. My gamepad, I explained it. Okay, let's go. This is the factory, right? McBain says, darn, it's locked. Come here. Gamero says, darn, I can't believe that they knew of our plans. Were they just chasing each other? But oh, they're hitting too. It's over! Prepare yourselves! Oh, wow. I understand how you feel, but this is my job. Don't get mad at me, says the soldier. I'll get mad at you if you want. If I want to. Takuto says, we're okay. Please go and help Sir Ector. Please, hurry to the basement of the exchanger, Ronald's son says. Please take care of Sir Ector. Are you in defiance against Sir Bureger? I'm always in defiance, Sir Bureger. Do not resist! Kiska's father says, Kiska is waiting. I can't lose now. We won't let you escape. Don't move. Oh boy. Bain says, you can't stop me. I'll show you what royal herbs can do. Maybe it increased their aggression as well. Make them fly into a murderous rage against these soldiers. We'll punish those that defy us. Punish, I tell ya. Stuck in there for a second. Buy some time for Sir Ector, says Aurora's father. What if I try to go this way? We can't abandon Kleina, says Ada. We have to do something. So the bunks are empty. So we'll go to the exchanger because the oh my god. Oh, stopping the spinning. We are worried about Sir Ector. Please hurry to the basement of the exchanger. This guy, he was sick not too long ago. Oh, what happened here? Is that a soldier? Oh, oong. Mina's mother says, "We believe in Sir Ector." Believe, believe. Kiska's mother says, "We're almost done digging. Sir Ector is in a tunnel." Searman says, "What are we going to do if Bureger already knew what we were going to do?" I don't know. Something else, maybe. Roraru's mother says, "Oh, you've finally come. Bureger already knew about our plans." Yeah. It's a sad state of affairs. Palman says, "I'm sorry. Bureger found out about us." "It's not your fault," says Forte. "Man, he pulled a quick one on us," McBain says. "If we destroy this wall," Palman says, "we'll be able to get to the power control room for the factory. Once the control equipment are all destroyed, we can stop all functions of this factory and bring them trouble." "Grandpa, can't you do anything about this wall?" "Sure, let me try. It's what you should have done in the first place." "What is he gonna do?" "Grandpa's special move. Go, go, Grandpa! Punch!" "Yeah, stand back, Palman." Nice. "Oh! Let's go," says McBain. "I'm going too," says Palman. Palman joins the party. Oh, he's level 33. He has a charged spear and sheet armor. We're not using the resurrect ring, and I'm not sure what the dotted ribbon does, but here. And Palman has a Valkyrie finishing move, or Valkyrie, have you said? A spear technique of a warrior protecting a maiden soldier. And then for skills, he's got combat command. An appropriate command raises the attack power and defense power. And dance raises the power gauges of comrades. Alright, let's throw a save in here. Been a while. Oh. Well, I want to look around the place. The factory will cease all functions once this is destroyed, Palman says. Let's do it, says McBain. Ow! Ow! This is hard. Man, this thing's sturdy, says Forte. No matter how sturdy it is, it's a machine, right? Machines are generally weak against lightning. Oh, that's right, says Forte. We have the Resonant Stone of Light. Well, here we go. If we can't explore this place... Ambassador Bureger says, "What is it?" It's a boom. I'm waiting for the cutscene to end so I can load a save, because I want to look around this place. The control room is destroyed, says the soldier. What? They use such annoying tactics, Bureger says. Fine, this makes it interesting. Get it ready. Palman says, "The factory should have ceased all functions now." Yeah, because I want to see what's there. I mean, maybe we can. Still see, but I just want to see what's there before we Because that's story stuff, so we should be going this way. Right. Leash bottle L. The leash bottle, I think that's... I'm trying to remember which one's magic. Cure. Okay, leash bottle L. Okay, great. Because that is... Yeah, fully restores magic points. This is the second one we've ever found. Never used it. Let me go. Cure bottle L. Nice. Yeah, a few more of those. I don't think we've ever used those either. Restore snuff. And resurrect powder, good, because we used one of those recently. Alright, so we got stairs up. Well, that's a dead end there. Palman says, let's go to the power control room. Alright, so now we did. The only thing we did is loot those chests first. Never mind then. Boom. Ow. Captain Palman and the McBain Company. Bureger, Palman says. Oh, stay calm, please. I am not your opponent, they are. What are you going to do? What? The villagers are saying kill. Kill. What the hell? A tournament of zombies? Kill. Palman. Kill. Kill. What's wrong with you? Says Palman. Well, they want to kill you. That's what's wrong with them. Is that a wooden soldier with a resonant stone inside? Says Palman. That's correct. But we got the resonant stone. The name of the resonant stone is Confusion. Ugh. I hate confusion. After I found out about the resonant stone and giraffe, someone gave me some information, and I successfully applied it to a wooden soldier. What? Who? Says McBain. These people now can't tell the difference between friend and foe. They are confused, but they will follow orders. Go, kill Palman. Well, we can't kill the villagers. I don't know if we have a chance to use non-lethal force on them or something? Magic cannot overcome us, Palman says. Well, we can't just stand around and watch either. Our bond can't be this weak. Mr. Palman, says Una. Why does she look happy? Unk. Gamera says, oh. Oh? Sir Roro's father says, Sir Ector is injured? Why? Says Renaldson. Siren says, Sir Ector?
What's going on? Why won't you fight? Fight and defeat Palmen!
McBain says, This resonant spell is simply a patched weapon. True bonds of the heart cannot be broken so easily.
Okay, everyone, says Forte. Take Sir Ector and leave at once.
Leave the rest to us, McBain says.
Now then, jerkies. I won't forget this, McBain Company. I'll leave the rest to you.
Yeah, you're running really quick, don't you? Okay, so two soldiers, Resonant. Okay, two soldiers and Resonant Soldier. So we just go after the big guy first? He's probably going to use confusion on us, and I hate that. Oh, the dog is hurt. That's not the best thing to have going on. If I had noticed that, I would have taken care of it before the fight. But interrupt. It's exactly the one we want to interrupt too. Unfortunately, now it's gonna be a while till we get another one of them. Missed. Oh, what did I do? It's Una who's hurt. Hurry up. I guess that's a skill. Is he, like, hasting them? Oh, wait. Hurry up makes him panic. I finally defeated that thing. Attack A. Yeah, Una will do the all heal. And Jan and Rick. What gets rid of panic? Panacea. Universal cure that works on all negative. Oh, anti-panic. Okay. Tranquil snuff for Forte. I'm not gonna bother using McBain's finishing move on these regular soldiers. Alright, time to heal. They're all going out of their way to just attack Forte for some reason. Okay, I was starting to wonder how long it would take to defeat one. Missed. All that sweet XP. Forte and his friends obtained the Resonant Stone of Confusion.
Wow.
And got a bonus stone from them. Grandpa, it looks like Bureger escaped upstairs. Okay, let's go after him. First. Resonant stone set on a wood soldier by Bureger confuses the enemy. Oh, that's outside. How do we get in that room? Oh, this is where we delivered our reports and stuff, I remember. We can go in and out now, at will. Alright, upstairs. Oops. Oh, hi. Mwahahaha, you have come at last. What the hell? Whoa, this is Forte. This is one of the fruits of our research. Why did you turn yourself into a giant bug? My body can change to be a bit more functional. To be more functional like this just by storing a little bit of the power of the Dark Sun. Get ready to feel my power. Alright, Punky. Let's hope we can do this. I haven't saved for a while. We'd have to fight that other thing again. Well, we'll keep interrupting Bureger. Wait. Oh, hold on. Yeah, Bureger. Bureger! I thought we were in the battle. Charge dog. Actually, sort of interrupted Bureger. Oh well. Interrupt Bureger now. Missed. Didn't miss. See what Bureger's gonna do, because I can't. Oh, now I can. Una will interrupt him. Oh, now he. Forte has his. I only want to interrupt Bureger with Forte's finishing move. Okay. Nice! Bureger has been defeated. Only one of us really needed that. I'm gonna interrupt the soldier. Oh, I didn't realize we had another soldier down there. Doggy heal. It was like that dog licked itself, all of a sudden it looks much better. Nice. One down. Oh, one to go. Oh, punch him. Boss battle extraordinaire. Well, of course. He's still alive. I like games where you... I mean, don't get me wrong, I like this game, but... I like it if you defeat the enemy... and they're dead. Or in this game, they become unconscious or something, or in a coma, if you don't want to be dead. It can't be! My body can't be defeated! The bad guys always lose, didn't you know? Says McMahon. It's not supposed to end this way. Yeah, it is. Emperor Rao's entrusted me to make this world under the control of Numeros. Emperor Rao's, huh? He's like telling all his secret plans. Ugh. Don't let him get away. I won't let you interfere. Oh, come on, guys, interfere. This is a parting gift from me. I'll be waiting for you on the other side. Don't you make me wait, McBain Company. Rag! What? Oh. Oh. Another battle? There are still more, says McBain. Ada says, wait, this is Capuri. What? Who's in there? That can't be, says Una. Capuri? Capuri says, G? Capuri? It's me, Ada. GG? Oh, that sounds supposed to mean. I'm sorry I'm so late. I came to get you. With Pedro, see? It looks like a dog or something. Cabri? GG? Ada, fall back, says Forte. Oh, we'll get knocked back. Ada! That's not Capuri anymore, says McBain. Forte! Yeah, Forte says. No, says Ada. Ada, that's not Capuri anymore, says McBain. Forte says, I can't do it. Una says, but we can't. No, says Ada. I'll stop Capuri. I'll stop Capuri with my own hands. Pedro! Capuri, stop it at once. If you don't, I'm going to have to break you. Oops. We're gonna have to break it. Pedro! Pedro, says Una. McBain says, Ada, this is it. Forte says, if Pedro gets hit any more, Ada herself will... Pedro! She's yelling. I'm sorry. Ada, tears blurring her vision, pulled on the strings to control Pedro. What is that? It's like a head of a dog or something. Capri! Sorry. I'm sorry. Pedro, forgive me. Ada. Capri says. Or Ida. Oh, he's just trying to say Ada. Capri? Is it like an artificial head? But it was inside the thing. Ada. Huh? Capri? Are you talking? Capri? Ada could have sworn that Capri, which was a puppet that had no way of talking, was calling her name. That was abrupt. Sir Ector, we were really worried about you, says Kiska. Palman says, I'm safe, thanks to everyone. Where's Ada? Asks McBain. She went upstairs to see Capri and Pedro, says Una. That's going to be hard on her, says McBain. The elder says, how's your injury? It's no big deal, says Palman. Gezalg and Clayta should be okay now. We have to save one more person, so we must head to the capital city of Pukasas. Elder, we leave the rest in your hands.
I gladly accept, but it'll be even harder to move if you're going to infiltrate the capital city, Pukasas.
But we need to collect information at the castle and stuff, says Forte. McBain says, we still have the person that's giving numerous information about the resonance stones to worry about. Una says, but it's impossible to walk around the castle unless we're numerous soldiers. Una, that's a good idea, says McBain. What? Grandpa, are you saying that we should become soldiers? Of course. So, Mr. Palman, what do we need to do to become soldiers? First, you need to volunteer, but of course, there are age restrictions. The only one that can pass in your group is, unfortunately, Forte, and that's if Forte lies about his age. We can't let Forte go in alone, says McBain. You sound like you're not very happy with that idea, says Forte. I'm worried about you. Palman says, but it's not like there aren't any exceptions. I've heard cases where entire towns have been officially hired as defensive forces in cases of emergencies when they have little manpower. They should be lacking in manpower because of the Dark Sun project and all right now. So if you show them what you can do, perhaps there's a chance that all of you will be hired. I have an idea, says Kiska. Why don't we have Ada make more fake wood soldiers and we can beat them up again? Fake wood soldiers? Says Palman. Forte says, when we were leaving Gezalg, we used that plan to fool the soldiers. I see. And all you have to do is defeat them. That's a great accomplishment. But, Una says. What, you're not happy with my plan? Says Kiska. Forte says, no, that's not it, but I don't think Ada can do that. Una says she's probably heartbroken after losing Capura and Pedro. I don't think she would be up to such a... Are you guys talking about me? Ada says, aw man, that's a bummer. Ada? Says Una. You don't have to worry so much about me. I'm okay. I can't be depressed forever. Capri and Pedro would make fun of me if I do that. I'll do it. I'll make an awesome fake wood soldier. You guys are going to help me, right? Ada, says Forte. McBain says, okay. We have no choice but to rely on you here. We're counting on you. Leave it to me. Let's get started.
Ada? What?
Are you really okay? Says Forte.
Yeah.
I'm not convinced. Thanks, Forte. Huh. Wow, so we get right into this place like that. I mean, it is how we got in there before, it's just funny. I didn't look all around, did I? I got interrupted again. Now let's look upstairs. There might be goodies. Right, so I looked in here, I looked in there. Alright, and then we went upstairs even more. Right, and this is where we had that big battle. Over here. This is where Bureger was hanging out the first time. We were like eavesdropping at the door. So there's nothing to be found here. Oh, just go out the door. Fancy that, using an actual door. Are all the soldiers gone? Batty says, now the factory has stopped, but there are wood soldiers on the roads. It's going to be a lot of trouble to get rid of them all. So did everyone go back then to Gezalg? Everybody's gone. This guy's here. Bane says, the problem is, what do we do with the factory? Destroy it completely? Or use it for something else? I would use it for something else. Practical considerations and all. Well, let's save here and go back to Did they all go back to Gezalg? Doesn't want to move over. Keep telling it no. Like, no, yes, 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 yes. So I save there in case there's really no reason to go back here. I'll just load. I haven't heard this song for a while. I like it. Well, that's the tuning fork.
Hmm.
Oops. I think this is the last screen before Gezalg. Awfully strange names that come up with these towns. Mina says, "Hey, it's my brother. Mommy came home." He's in midair. Yay, yay, Mom's back. Dad's back, says Roraru. Didn't mean to hit that. I don't think he'd say anything new, but... So I'll go visit everyone. Kiara says, "Man, such a dangerous world this has become." That's right. Any new stuff? Oh, that's right, I don't have everybody with me. I don't think he has anything new, though. You guys had a rough day. It's on me tonight. Please, drink. Yeah, three of them will have juice. Actually, it's just Forte and Jan and Rick. Yeah, no one's having alcohol. He's underage, and we're not getting the dog drunk today, so... Mina's father says, "I feel lucky to be back, thanks to Forte and his friends and Sir Ector." Well, that's you're talking to Forte. Roraru's father says, "This was a meeting place for the village. The soldiers were using it without permission. We have to clean it up." Oh, that's right. This is the place I couldn't get into at all. That's why I don't remember going in there. Okay. Alright, so this is the inn. Oh boy. That's cruel. We went all the way down there and just get stuck. Talk to her. That's the same one. Kiska's father. Oh, Forte, are you alone? Kiska and Sir Ector just headed to Clayta. We just came from Clayta. They just left Clayta. I think that's it for what's down here. Yeah. Ronald's son says, I'm glad my father is okay. Now I can spoil him rotten. He's pretty old to be your father. He's more like your grandfather. What's going on in the capital? Says Siren. Hell if we should know.
It's so nice! Now I can live together with my son and his wife! Thank you!
Oh, well the son's grown up. Okay. That makes sense, Don. So unless he has another kid? How is he a grandpa? Get in there. Roro's mother says, I'm glad Mina and Roro are okay. There's nothing that makes me happier. Grandma Raccoon.
Wow, Forte! You came alone? Serector and Kisco were here not too long ago. Too bad that you just missed each other.
Yeah, run all the way back?
Oh, I'm trying to talk to her.
Mina's mother says, we were able to come back, thanks to you and your friends. Thank you. Well, hopefully the elder is there and he'll provide some insight. Is here, rather. Not there. Who's this? Takuto says, we need to revive Gezalg and Kleda. We'll all work together to achieve that. Well, where's the elder? So he's going back to Kleda now.
Alright.
If I have to. Curious, because now we can walk through this without any problems. All right, back we go. We find our party members then. Go that way. Or that way. Whole lot of running going on. Yes, I'm wondering how close we are to the end. Sounds like we're going to some castle. There's going to be some epic battle or something. With Emperor Rousen. Alright, you just walk right in my way. Almost there. I don't... Okay. So now it says they went back here. At least that's what the villagers are saying, and we just missed them or something. Oh, we still can't go in that door? Why is that? No, no thank you. We can't go in? Oh wait, we can go in this way. I'm tired of walking around looking for people. Going from one place to the other. Okay. Karutsu says, I never thought I'd end up making wood soldiers again. This time it's fun, though. It might be down to the exchanger. I'm going to make a really scary wood soldier. I'm going to scare the wits out of the Bukasa's soldiers. Nobody ever took the stairs down? I don't remember. Forte, do you think Ada's okay? Were they just here in the factory the whole time? I mean, at least we got to see what the villagers had to say. Ada's a strong girl, says McBean, but the shock of losing Capuri and Pedro must be huge. Oh, the elder's here.
Sir Hector and Kiska are at Gezalg to get Kuroto's yarn.
No, they came back already. Sir Hector and Kiska are late. Yeah. They're not at either town, so... That's a little worrisome. Oh, there's Ada. Okay, we'll talk to her last. If anyone's running around, messing around up here until we go to... unless... then we'll go downstairs. Alright, there's no one up here. Oh, this is where all that happened. This was downstairs. Oh, okay. Let's see if anyone's in this little hideout. Nope. Okay. Where is she again? I see her.
Ada.
Yes? Oh, nothing. Be careful. Thanks. I'm okay as long as I have you guys. See? Ada smiled as usual. Yeah. So how's it going? I heard that these wood soldiers are made by using Capuri as a model, but a copy is just a copy. They can't duplicate my grandpa's techniques. They really simplified the design, so it's easy to just be able to make them move. All you need is for Kiska to bring Kurodo's yarn. They're so late. I wonder where they're goofing around. Forte, can you go take a look? Kiska and Palmin are so late. Will you go see what's going on? If I have to. The more Ada tries to be cheerful, I understand how she feels, says Una. Ada's a strong girl. That's the same thing he said before. Mm-hmm. Yeah, alright, I guess we're... What do we do, start hanging back to Gezalg again? Oh, good. Kiska says, hey, Forte. Palmin says, how's Ada doing? Is her operation going as planned? Forte says, she says that she's done after she puts on Kuroto's yarn. I see. Well, let's go and deliver it then. Good, I was worried I'd have to go look for them and go back to Gezalg again. Hey, I have a request for you, says Ada.
What is it? I'll listen to any wish that you make.
I want you to hold Capuri and Pedro, who are broken, for me. I'll come back after we rescue Aria. I don't know if I can fix them, but even if I can't, I want to take them home to Grandpa.
You're right. I'm sure deep inside, you want to repair Capuri and Pedro instead of making fake wood soldiers. I understand, Ada. I'll take responsibility of Capuri and Pedro. Thank you.
Ada, I brought you the yarn, says Palmin. Palmin gave Kroto's yarn to Ada. Thank you. This will finish the project. I'm done. I'm worried about Aria, says Palmin. Let's start the operation. McBain says, okay then everyone, we're leaving now.
Please be careful.
Ada says, please take care of Capuri and Pedro.
Leave them to me.
Palmin says, Kiska, you're in charge of Gezalg and Kleda.
Wow.
Isn't he a kid? He's in charge of two towns? Yes, Sir Hector. Well, we're off, says Forte. Kiska says, Forte, Una, Ada, be careful. But not McBain. Kiska, you too, says Una. We'll be back, says Ada. Troops, forward! Forte says, we just chase after the wood soldiers and beat them up after they're discovered by the soldiers, right?
Yup.
Okay, let's go after them. Let's go around one more time and talk to everybody before we head on our way. Once this place is settled down, we'll organize a team to destroy the wood soldiers. Leave that to us. I'll leave it to you. No worries. That batty again? I'll take this way. How's Pukasas? Was it dangerous? Says Gamera. We haven't been there yet. I'll go ahead and disassemble the machinery in the plant to make it so that they're usable. Okay, you do that. Sir Ector, don't worry about it. Please leave this place to us. Leave this place to us. Okay. So we have a bunch of rills. Please get out of my way. That looked intentional. See, the horn helmet brings the attack way up. But I don't know what it is normally. Maybe not way up. What's his attack? 213. All right, so it brings him up 8 points. And this will bring up McBain's attack and defense. ...190, 155. Oh, that's Ada. 159, 126. Let's take this off. I want to know what it does. The red bandana. Step away from the counter. I want to see what this does. Oh, it's going to be in items. Oh no, accessories. Increases attack power. ...149 and 124. Alright, so we'll get the horn helmet for him. Oh, it's 1,000 rills. Oh, these are all 1,000 rills. Well, not all, but... a lot. Yeah, this exchanges rills to gents, in which case we can't buy anything because we won't have any rills. Oh, we can't get more because we sell things for gents. And That's a bummer. If there's any way to change gents back to reals, probably not. Not that I've ever seen. Alright, is there anything good we can afford? What's a drowsiness proof thing? Purifying? Yeah. Oh well. You really gotta gather those rills together. It's our first time out here. Okay. So, next episode, heading towards Pukasas. Another town with a funny name. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.